Hi folks, this is Jake. Hope you're okay today. It's good to see you. We're looking at historical Jesus studies, and we're looking at this scholar. I believe in the historical Jesus, I. Howard Marshall. He's a top scholar, and we're going to read a little bit of what he says on history and faith, and then we're going to listen to him on biblical interpretation, and then I'm going to give you my thoughts. And I'll link to the guy because he's a major scholar. We now come back to the historical Jesus. From that has just been said, it is clear that the statement, I believe in the historical Jesus, can convey a number of different ideas. It could mean I trust in Jesus. A typical form of service for persons becoming members of the Church of Jesus Christ include the question, do you truly repent of your sin and believe in the Lord Jesus Christ as your Saviour? When the candidate replies, I do, he obviously means more than he simply believes in the existence of Jesus, the fact that he is portrayed in the Bible as a saviour. It means that he puts his trust in Jesus to act as a saviour to him, and that he declares his allegiance to Jesus. We are not concerned with this kind of belief at this point in our inquiry. We are dealing with the prior question, whether there was a historical Jesus who can be regarded as a saviour. Today, I believe in the historical Jesus is therefore to say, I believe that Jesus existed and that he said and did such and such. But why do we believe rather than know? In this statement, one reason is that we are experiencing conviction and taking up a position. There are people who do not believe in Jesus in this way, and we are declaring a stance over against them. Where other people may scoff at the policy of, say, the Liberal Party, the person who says that he believes in the Liberal Party is affirming his conviction that its policies are right and good for the nation. We use I believe to express a conviction in matters that are disputed, or very often in matters like politics and religion where we have strong feeling on the subject. This is Howard Marshall on biblical interpretation.
Clearly, these two commitments to academic study and to Christian witness are interrelated. It is increasingly recognized that we cannot separate them the one from the other. Now, it is the latter task, the one of expressing the Christian message for today, which is my particular focus in this series. In Heidegger, with the result that even in his New Testament theology, which is meant to be telling us what the New Testament writers said for their time, nevertheless, we get a demonologized version of what they said. Bultmann, in other words, is setting out to some extent what Christians ought to believe today, rather than simply describing the theology of the New Testament on its own terms. Now, until comparatively recently, evangelicals, like biblical scholars and preachers generally, didn't recognize just how great the problems are in these three areas. Of course, there were handbooks of biblical interpretation. In my student days, for example, the British scholar Alan Stibbs wrote three little booklets for students at a fairly non-technical level, one of which was called Understanding God's Word. Some of us suggested at the time that he might also have written a book on liberal interpretation of the Bible, which would have been called Misunderstanding God's Word. A typical example of our juvenile pride, and a typical evangelical claim that we alone are right and everybody else is wrong. Nevertheless, there was a growing awareness of the need for deeper discussion.
So he's talking about hermeneutics there, and I think that hermeneutics is grossly exaggerated. I think that it's very simple, stick to the historical grammatical method, that is to stick to the context. And read the old writers like the Puritans and early church fathers and let them inspire you. And just do your biblical studies. You don't have to get into a philosophy in hermeneutics. You do that and you'll lose the plot. On the historical Jesus studies, And faith. I think the Christian faith is connected to two. We believe in the objective facts of history, but we also have an experience of the living Christ. All right. Thank you for listening and take care.